Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. We are from group 5 and this time we will present about monitoring of plant pathogenic inoculum in water and air. Before present, I will introduce group member of group 5. Number 1, it's me, Muhammad Ari Setia Nugroho, student number 149.
Hello guys, my name is Nadia Nora and my student number is 163.
Hello, my name is Pan Variasan with name 134118164.
Hello, I'm Anissa Erkawati with student number 168.
I'm Gracila Nanda Puspitasari with student number 169.
Okay, and next introduction. The problem of plant pathogens in irrigation water is aggravated by the increasing use of recycled water. Recycling irrigation in some locations is crucial to comply with strict water policy and regulation. As a concern of water security spread, agriculture use of resources is being my closest monitoring and regulation by government. Dispersal in air is one of many mechanisms by which plant pathogens spread towards the new surgical plants in air within the same field in a camp completely different conditions.
Okay, the first one we will discuss about detection and monitoring pathogens in the water. Detection threshold of any sampling method employed must be verified. Every step in the procedure may influence the number of pathogens detected. You have to know that numerous techniques already employed in pathogens detections and new ones are being developed. Fungi, bacteria, and nematodes can be trapped on the filters, resuspended, and observed directly. For pathogens that can be cultured, the filter can be plated directly on a media or this residues washed from the filter, then plated on general or semi-selective media. Okay, next one. Water samples also can be centrifuged to concentrate organism and the pellet suspended and planted. The sample can be amended with an appropriate nutrient and incubated when the target organism is suspected to be present in extremely low numbers. Centrifugations combined with direct observation via electron microscopy, indicator plant inoculation, etc. Another frequently used method for detection is baiting with plant parts or whole trap plants and planting the colonized tissue into a media. The trap plant or bait detection's efficacy and pathogen species selectivity must be examined. A significant problem that sometimes rapid and extensive colonizations by no target organism.
Immunochemical technique enable very sensitive detection and sometimes identification of the pathogen to the species level. Theoretically, the method with the greatest resolution for DNA-containing organism is polymerase chain reaction, or PCR, amplification of DNA. DNA can be extracted from the residue on the filter paper, colonized on plates, plates from centrifugation, or colonized plates. Amplification can be done with universal or species-specific primers, PCR DGA, or DNA Turing gradient electrophoresis is widely used to assess the structure of microbial communities in environmental samples without culturing. DNA array technology is a means of monitoring multiple species of pathogen in sample. If more than one species of plant pathogen is found in the irrigation water, as is often the case, it may be assumed the certain species are highly pathogenic and their presence at any level is of serious concern. But many other species are secondary parasites or only able to cause crop loss at other specific conditions.
Next is the method detection and monitoring pathogen in the air. Number 1, air samplers. Number 2, impactor. Number 3, cyclone and wet cyclone. Number 4, electrostatic impactor and impingers. Number 5, virtual impactor. Number 6, filters. Number 7, non-capture or optional monitoring. Explanation of air samples. Airborne particulate can be sampled in a number of different ways. Be different in aspect of air sample flow rate, collection efficiency, which using varies with particle size, power consumption, length of sample period, length of period they can be leaf united and easy of processing the sample. Curtain spore were present in the air, which can be associated with various environmental, rain, wind, temperature, or humidity effect, or optional variable, mechanical or human mediation operation.
Okay, number two is infectures. Infectures can have relatively high collection efficiency above a certain cut-off particle size and can also sample at relatively high volume rate. Microtire immunospore trap or MTIST works by impaction of air direct through a series of trumpet-like passage opening into each well of a microtire plate. Number three is cyclone and wet cyclone. The miniature cyclone or multi-vital cyclone was developed to simplify handling of the sample by sampling directly into an Eppendorf tube for easy application of immunological or DNA-based diagnostic method rather than microscopy. Number four is electrostatic impactor and impingers. Impingers bubble air through a liquid which is good at collecting very small particles that would not be impacted with high efficiency because of them changing direction with the airflow. This type of sampler can only be operated of short periods unless the collection liquid is topped up to replace liquid lost by evaporation.
Next, virtual impactors. Virtual impactors force a jet of air into a chamber where the airflow changes direction, causing particles that have a greater momentum than air molecules to spread from the main airflow. The jet spore trap is a type of virtual impactor that was used by Limpert to sample large volumes of air into a settling chamber above petri dish containing detached leaves of cereal plants. 6. Filters. Filters usually have a low flow rate because of resistance caused by the filter. The filter is designed to have a very large surface area. And then last, non-capture or optical monitoring. This class of samplers or sensors operate not necessarily by capturing a sample but by using various optical sensors to analyze particles either suspended in the air, passed in an airstream past a sensor, or entrained from air into a liquid that is then passed by sensor. Okay, thank you for your attention. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.